Following his release at Kireka Special Investigations Directorate in Kampala, the seemingly weak Yusuf Kawoya was immediately taken to Kampala Hospital by the family for medical attention. At the hospital, Kawoya's relatives and politicians gathered to check on him. However, they were kept out of the treatment ward for several hours before they could be allowed in. He was subjected to several bodily checkups, and it was revealed that he sustained a number of injuries during the brutal arrest. Kawoya can barely sit or stand without any support. He is coughing severely and painfully and talks with a lot of difficulty. And most worrying, he is oozing blood and pus out of his ears. He tried to explain his ailments, but with difficulty. According to relatives, Kawoya could have sustained internal injuries on some of the delicate body organs as a result of the brutal manner in which he was arrested.
Have been told by him that he has pain near the kidney, he has chest pain, and he feels numbness on this side of the ear, which we want to further investigate. The doctors are still working hard to make sure that they find out what the challenges are.
They also fear that he could have acquired pneumonia after spending several hours in a cold room where he was kept for more than 5 days.
The patient is complaining about the blood which is coming out of his ears. So he has been bleeding, I think, for the last 3 days.
Alinga ina pneumonia. Kubanga abadde asula mu mpewo basically. Erecho tubadde tukisubira.
After several checkups at Kampala Hospital, Kawoya was put into an ambulance and rushed to Kampala Imaging Center for a full body CT scan to confirm fears of internal injuries. Footage of Kawoya's violent arrest by a group of gun-wielding men last week went viral, sparking off widespread condemnation. One of the men was seen hitting the helpless Kawoya with the butt of his gun during the chaotic episode before he was shoved into a commuter van and driven off to an unknown destination as people watched on helplessly. 5 military suspects were paraded before the UPDF Unit Disciplinary Court on Saturday and pleaded guilty to unprofessional conduct while carrying out the arrest.
You executed an operation without following standard operating procedures.